Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. Welcome to Get That Extra Edge series. This is Srinivas Reddy. I am presently working as academic dean and senior maths faculty in India's topmost Sri Chaitanya education institutions. As you know, in this series I am discussing the advanced question paper 2020. You have seen the previous videos also. In this video I am going to discuss the question given in properties of triangle. Look at this question. This is a multiple answer question, one or more correct answer type, which carries 4 marks, and part marks will also be there. Right? Look at this question. Look at this question. Let x comma y comma z be lengths of sides of a triangle opposite to angles x, y, z. That means a triangle x, y, z is given. Let us collect the data from the question step by step. So that means there is a triangle x, y, z is given opposite to angle x. The side is small x given, opposite to y, small y is given. This yz is small x, this zx is small y, opposite to angle z, this small z is given. That means capital XY is given as z, like this information is given. So, and also one condition is given, tan x by 2 plus tan z by 2 equal to 2y divided by x plus y plus z, then options are given like this, right? So let us analyze. Generally, in triangle ABC, we will have usual notation. We will be comfortable if the triangle is ABC other than XYZ, because all the formulas are in ABC. That's why for convenience, I am taking x as angle A, capital A, this is angle B, this is angle C. Let us say for convenience, I will solve the problem in triangle ABC. So if triangle ABC is there opposite to angle A, what is the side called? Let us say this is small a. This, so that means this is BC, that is small a. Similarly CA, this is what usual notation, B, this is what C. Now convert the problem to triangle ABC. Now look at that condition will transform to tan A by 2 less tan capital C divided by 2 equal to 2 into, this is B, y is what, B divided by small a plus small b plus small c. So this is the condition given. Now look at what is required. This condition is given. He is asking 2y equal to a plus b plus c. If this answer has to be correct, let us analyze. Capital X plus capital Y plus capital Z is what? Sum of angles is what? 180 degree. So now if this first option has to be true, X plus Z is what? 2y. That means for option A has to be true, so that means this will become 3 capital Y equal to 180 degree. First option means that y equal to 60 degree. If you prove that y equal to 60 degree, then first option is correct. So next option B, look at, first analyze how the problem can be solved. Option B, if this has to be true, in this, if in place of x plus z, if you substitute y, 2y equal to 180 degree. That means if you prove that capital Y is 90 degree, then obviously x plus z will be what? 90 degree. So for option A, to prove, you have to prove that y equal to 60 degree. for option B to be true, we have to prove that capital Y equal 90 degree. That means first we will find out angle Y and then proceed with the option C and option D. That is our approach to this problem. Now, approach 1. Let us discuss different approaches of solving the problem. Approach 1. My target is calculating angle Y. Calculating angle Y means, what is that? Calculating angle B. Angle B. As angle is wanted, I want to convert completely into angle sides also. So that means approach 1 is half angles are there. That means A by 2 plus B by 2. Half angles is what? 90 degrees. This identity will be there in triangle. A by 2 plus B by 2 plus C by 2 is what? 90 degree. So as tan is there, I am converting into sine and cos. So first choice is converting into sine and cos. Sine and cos. Now 2 into this is 2r sine b. Convert into angles. So sine rule is what? B is 2r sine b. So this is 2r sine a, this is 2r sine b, this is 2r sine c. Take 2r common. Sine a plus sine b plus sine c. I want to convert into angles. So 2r, 2r got cancelled. So now take the LCM of this. Cos A by 2, cos C by 2, this is the one. Now if you take the LCM here, you can observe sin A by 2 cos C by 2 plus cos A by 2 sin C by 2. That is like sin of alpha plus beta. That means this is sin of A by 2 plus C by 2. So this is nothing but 2 into, I am converting into half angles. This is 2 sin B by 2 cos B by 2 divided by, now sin A plus sin B plus sin C. You have famous identities. Sin A plus sin B plus sin C is what? Famous identities. Triangle ABC, 4 cos A by 2, cos B by 2, cos C by 2. That is famous identity. There are two identities I am writing here which will be of great use while solving the problem. Sigma sin A. This is one identity. Here we are applying that. You can prove easily, try it. In properties of triangles, these two identities, you will get more in the problems. Directly you have to apply. Sigma cos A you will get 1 plus 4 sin A by 2, sin B by 2, sin C by 2. These two are identities. You can easily prove it. You write sin A plus sin B transformation and then take common, then you will get right. So now look at, so if you observe here, you got A by 2 plus C by 2. A by 2 plus C by 2 is what? 90 degree in triangle. 90 degree minus B by 2. Look at here. A by 2 plus C by 2 is nothing but 90 degree minus B by 2. So this will become cos B by 2, this cos B by 2, this cos B by 2 will get cancelled. Now cos A by 2, cos C by 2, cos A by 2, cos C by 2 will get cancelled. So 4 and 2 will get cancelled. Now you got, right hand side if you see, you got tan B by 2. sin b by 2 by cos b by 2 you got. So left hand side is 1. So that means this is nothing but 45 degrees. That means b by 2 is what? 45 degree. That means angle B is nothing but 90 degree. Angle B is what? Angle Y is nothing but, it is given in the question, angle Y. So if angle Y equal to 90 degree, obviously angle Y plus angle Z equal to 90. So we come to the conclusion that B option is correct. B option is correct, and it is a right angle triangle. And it is a right angle triangle, right angle that angle Y, angle X plus Z. So therefore, we can conclude that capital Y equal to capital X plus J. So this is the correct answer. Now you have concluded that it is a right angle triangle. It is a right angle triangle. Now look it. So this is the right angle triangle. I will construct once again. This is a right angle triangle. I will construct angle B equal to 90 degree like this for solving the problem. I am constructing again. So angle B equal to 90 degree. Let us see, this is angle B. This is angle A. This is angle C. Right? This is 90 degree. Let us say. So this is side C. This is side A. And this is side B. Right? So that means we can say that B square equals to A square plus C square. Now if you look at the third option, let us do this option. Third option you take, that means tan C by 2 is nothing but A divided by B plus C. This is tan A by 2. Tan A by 2 is nothing but, you have to calculate tan A by 2. If this is true in this triangle, then it will be true. So tan A by 2 means I am drawing an angular bisector. Okay. Let us do like this. I am drawing an angular bisector. This is A by 2. This is A by 2. A by 2, let us say AD is angular bisector, let us say this is AD. AD is angular bisector. From the triangle I want to write tan A by 2. Tan A by 2 is nothing but BD divided by AB, that means C. BD divided by C. This is in triangle ABD. So that means if you calculate that BD, you will get tan A by 2. Now look at, AD is the angular bisector. AD is the angular bisector. Now D divides, this is the point where angular bisector meets the opposite sides. D divides BC. BC in, what is the ratio? D divides BC in the ratio, BC in the ratio, AB in the ratio of arms of the triangle. AB is to AC, that is angular bisector property. AB is to AC. AB is to AC. This is the point where angular bisector meets the opposite side. So we have the property D divides BC in the ratio AB is to AC. That means AB is to AC means what? AB is nothing but C is to B. C is to B. C is to B. That means what is this ratio actually? BD. BD is to DC is nothing but C is to B. Right, ratio this is, not BD equal to C, ratio. Let us take BD equal to KC comma proportionality constant, let us say this proportionality constant, let us say K. Now we have BD plus DC. We have to calculate K. BD plus DC is nothing but BC. So that means BD plus DC is what? K into C plus B equal to BC is what? V. That implies K is nothing but A divided by B plus C. Right? So therefore, what is BD? BD is nothing but KC. BD is nothing but KC. BD is nothing but KC. So that means tan A by 2 is nothing but BD divided by C. That means BD is nothing but what is that? KC. KC divided by C. Right? So therefore, K is nothing but what? A by B plus C. Look at this. Tan A by 2 is nothing but, purely from the diagram I have done, tan A by 2 is nothing but A divided by B plus C. Therefore, what is angle A actually? Tan x by 2 equals to, this is small y plus small b. So this is true. Obviously, as angle y is 90 degree, this is false. Now look at here. Is this true or not? So actually, what is the relation? B square equal to A square plus C square. Look at, B square equal to A square plus C square means Y square equals to X square plus Z square. Y square equal to X square plus Z square. Look at here, X square plus Z square is what? Y square. Left hand side is 0. So you will get X into Z equal to 0. That means this is incorrect. So both this option and this option are correct. This is incorrect because you are getting product of sides equal to 0. Right? Like that, this is one approach. This is basic approach. Now, approach 2 we will see. Just formula approach. Look at it. Let us see approach 2. Another approach to this problem. Another approach to solve this problem is approach 2. So tan A by 2 plus tan C by 2 equal to 2B divided by A plus B plus C. In triangle ABC we have the formula. Look at it. Tan A by 2, half angle formula it is called. This is formula is what actually basic formula is S minus B into S minus C divided by S into S into S minus E. This is basic formula, half angle formula. Or we can write it in this manner also. S minus B into S minus C divided by delta. So that is tan A by 2. Tan A by 2. Formula wise, in this problem, tan A by 2 is nothing but S minus B into S minus C divided by delta. This you can write, or this you can write. Just this and this are same. In the root, you multiply numerator and denominator with S minus B into S minus C. So numerator you will get this one, denominator root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. So this is the formula for tan A by 2. Similarly, cot A by 2 will be there, half angle formula. Actually, basic formula is root of S into S minus A divided by S minus B into S minus C, or you can write the formula as S into S minus A divided by delta. So look at here, tan A by 2 is there, tan A by 2, what is the formula here? S minus B into S minus C divided by delta plus S minus A into S minus B divided by delta. This is nothing but 2B divided by 2S. This is perimeter. Perimeter. Perimeter is what? 2S is nothing but sum of all the sides. Sum of all the sides. 2 got cancelled. Now take S minus B common. You got 2S minus C. S minus C plus S minus A divided by delta. Why I have taken the second formula is such that you will get a common denominator. Common denominator. So B divided by S. Now 2S minus C minus A. This is nothing but B. So this is nothing but what? B. Look at 2S minus C minus A is nothing but B. That means bring S this side. S into S minus B divided by delta is nothing but 1. Is nothing but 1. What is this one? S into S minus B divided by delta. S into S, see, look at it. S into S minus A divided by delta is what? Cot A by 2. That means this is nothing but cot B by 2. Cot B by 2 is nothing but 1. Therefore, B by 2 is what? 45 degree. So, B is what? 90 degree. That implies B is our capital Y. That means capital X plus capital Z is also 90 degree. So, therefore, what is correct? This option is correct. B option is correct. So now coming to the this is B option. Coming to the C option, you have to calculate. I am calculating tan A by 2. Let us say this is first equation. Tan A by 2 formula is what? Yes, this is purely based on formula, this approach. Divided by delta. Right? Now, if you look at here, from 1 delta is what? Divided by delta is nothing but S into S minus B. This is from 1. Now S minus B got cancelled. Tan A by 2 in terms of sides are there. That means now I am writing tan A by 2. tan a by 2 is nothing but, tan a by 2 is nothing but 2s, I am multiplying it and divided by 2, divided by 2s. So 2s is what? A plus b plus c. 2s is a plus b plus c minus 2c divided by a plus b plus c. That means I will get a plus b minus c divided by a plus b plus c. Now here you got angle B equal to 90 degree. So this is 90 degree. This is 90 degree means, this is 90 degree means you will get hypotenuse square. B square equals to, B square equals to A square plus C square. A square plus C square. That implies C square, bring this side. B plus C into B minus C is nothing but A square. A square. So now I am substituting here in place of B minus C. So here A plus B minus C, I am replacing it as A square divided by B plus C divided by A plus B plus C. Now if you take the LCM, if you take the LCM, A into B plus C, A into B plus C plus A square is what? If I take A common divided by B plus C into this. So you got A divided by B plus C. A is what? X divided by Y plus Z. X divided by Y plus Z. This is second approach to the problem. This is second approach to the problem. So let us see third approach. Last approach you will get very easily. Look at substitution method. Third approach. Look at. So some clever students, some clever students, how they will approach the problem. Look at. How they will approach the problem. Let us discuss in the third approach. Alternate approach this is. Third approach. Approach 3. Approach 3. Right? So let us take A. Let us take A option. A option means clearly when this will be true, you know. XY equal to 60 degree. So Y equal to 90 degree. Y equal to 90 degree. Now let us take triangle XYZ is equilateral. Is equilateral. Is equilateral. So Y equal to 60 degree means I am taking capital X equal to capital Y equal to capital Z equal to 60 degree and small x small y equal to small z equal to 60 degree equal to equal, they are equal. Now if this is true, whether that is true or not you check. That means tan, substitute here, x is what? 60 degree. So 30 degree plus tan 30 degree LHS equal to 2x divided by 3x. Now what you are getting here left hand side, 2 by root 3 equal to 2 by 3, this is wrong. So therefore it is equilateral triangle is wrong. That means capital Y cannot be 60 degree. Capital Y cannot be 60 degree. So A is eliminated. A is eliminated. A is incorrect. And if you look at here, C option, x square plus x square, C option if you take. So left hand side is what? X square plus x square minus x square. That side is what? X square. You got x square equal to x square. This you are getting true. If you take equilateral triangle, this condition you are getting true. So this condition is false. That means if capital Y equals 60 degree, then this condition is what? False. That means this condition is also false you are getting. But this you are getting correct. But given condition is not true in equilateral triangle. Therefore, this and obviously equilateral triangle is not possible. Just this equation is getting satisfied. Therefore, option A and option B are incorrect. So that means, so these are incorrect. Now look at B option. So B option, capital Y equal to 90 degree. That means let us take capital Y equal to 90 degree. Capital Y equal to 90 degree means right angle triangle. Capital Y equal to 90 degree. Write x, y, z. Like this you take. So this is z. So this is x. So this is y. This is y. Now capital Y equal to 90 degree. Now you take capital X equal to capital Z equal to 45 degree for convenience. Right? Take right angled isosceles triangle. Let us say this is 45 degree. And check whether given condition is true or not. That means here right angled triangle means this is also, these both will be equal. That means 2x square equal to y square. That means y is nothing but root 2x. Now given condition is true or not, you check. Tan capital X by 2, 22 and half degree plus, so tan X by 2, X by 2 is what? Tan 22 and half degree plus tan Z by 2, tan 22 and half degree. This, so tan X by 2 plus tan Z by 2, this is nothing but 2 into y is nothing but root 2x divided by x plus root 2x plus x. Z is nothing but x. So tan 22 and half, you know, tan 22 and half is what? Root 2 minus 1. This is standard value. So now you got here 2 root 2 divided by root 2 plus 2. So let us simplify this. Root 2 will get cancelled, 2 divided by root 2 plus 1. If you take the rationalizing, we multiply with root 2 minus 1, then denominator will become 1. Now look at these both are equal. These both are equal means what? So angle Y equal to 90 degree is true. Angle Y equal to 90 degree is true. So this is the one, this is true. Now for this type of triangle, let us check. So this is B option. Now let us see C option. Tan x by 2 is nothing but tan 22 and half degree. That is root 2 minus 1. Now let us check x by y plus a. You are getting these equal or not? So xy root 2x plus x. So 1 by root 2 plus 1. This is nothing but root 2 minus 1. Therefore, option C is correct. Option B is correct for a right angle triangle. Therefore, this is true and this is true. Like that third approach. This is analytical approach, clever approach. We will take the option and we will proceed with the problem. Like that you have to analyze. Okay, now. So this is about this question. Look at how many number of approaches are there. Approach 1, directly sine rule approach. Approach 2, substituting the formula tan A by 2, tan B by 2 and cot A by 2, cot B by 2, like that. Third approach is by proceeding with the options. So taking the option and then proceeding to the problem, whether the given condition is correct or not, like that. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. So my main aim is to explore these many number of approaches is, so finally in the exam, it will work out for any approach. It can work out for any approach in the exam while you are writing the final examination. If you are trained up with these skills, you will get easily the question in any approach. Like that, you always think of different type of approaches. Okay, anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe and like my channel and refer to your friends also. And happy Vijayadashmi to all of you. I hope so. Next coming season will give you victory towards your target. Thank you all of you. Have a nice day.